First of all, I'd like to thank all of you for coming today, and for the Waite Park Chamber and for Falcon National Bank for sponsoring this event. I'd also like to acknowledge members of our City Council, including Frank Tyson. I don't know if Frank's here. Mike Lindquist, I know he's here. I don't know if Chuck Schneider, and Vic Schultz, and I know Vic's here. With our recent elections, I'm pleased to inform you that Mike Lindquist and Chuck Schneider and I have been reelected, for better or for worse, but I guess that puts some consistency into what I think you can expect from Waite Park in the next few years. We remain committed to the Waite Park community and are very excited to share with you many things that are going on in our community. The work of our council and our staff has been instrumental in the city being able to accomplish many great things. I would like to take this opportunity to turn this over to our City Administrator, Shauna Johnson, and our other department heads, and they will tell you, keep you up to date on what we've done. I know some of you have been here for all the meetings during the year, and so some of you have gotten updates, some of you haven't, but this will be a combination of that, and hopefully you'll realize that the city has done a lot of great things. Before I forget this, and I will forget it otherwise, I want you to all look to that wall right over there. It says Waite Park Pizza Ranch. Thank you, Pizza Ranch.
Well, I can officially say good afternoon. I always like when people are looking at their clocks to tell whether or not we're in the morning or afternoon at these events. A little bit short, so I've got to adjust. As we look over the last 20 years, many things have changed in our society. It was only a decade ago that a blackberry was a mere summer fruit. Green was just a color. Cameras used film. And tweet was something that birds did. Like the changes that we have seen in society, we too have seen many of these same changes in Waite Park. Our community looks very different than it did then. A community that was once often referred to as the village of Waite Park and a community with a strong railroad heritage has changed. We are now a community home to a growing diverse population with the largest percentage of people who were foreign-born in another country in the St. Cloud metro area. In addition to this, we also have the largest percentage of people who are 65 or older living in Waite Park. While our overall population has not increased significantly in the last 20 years, we have seen a significant increase in development and in our daytime population, impacting the services that we provide. As we continue to look forward, we are focusing our efforts on embracing our changing community. From our use of technology, our demand for 24/7 services, our need to enhance security, to our changing demographics, we are a community that recognizes our need to adapt and to be forward-thinking. As we look forward, it is important to highlight many accomplishments of 2016. The city continues to be financially strong and fiscally responsible with its fund, while still providing a high level of services to our community. Over the last 3 years, the city's tax rate has declined slightly by just under 1%. We have seen small increases in our overall tax capacity, and we have still managed to complete many needed capital improvement projects. As we look to 2017, we anticipate seeing some increases in our overall tax capacity as a result of commercial development activity, and are hopeful that property valuations will continue to be steady. Our recent annexation of the remaining part of St. Joe Township will also add to our tax valuation over time. The key to our budgeting success is planning and anticipating the needs of our community. Our capital improvement plan that outlines our needs for the next 5 to 10 years is key to the city remaining financially strong. Now I'd like to turn it over to John Nuremberg, our Community Development Director, to talk about community development occurring in Waite Park.
2016 was a good year for commercial construction in Waite Park. We had 10 new commercial buildings that started construction that totaled over $27 million. This is a large increase in comparison to last year with three new commercial buildings that previously totaled $2.4 million. Included in this new construction for 2016 are two new hotels, which are the Hilton Garden Inn and a Residence Inn, and Conference Center, as well as our new Public Works building. Other new commercial development includes Hobby Lobby, adjacent to the Home Depot, Luther Honda, located west of Menards on Highway 23, Five Below, Dick's Sporting Goods, Mattress Firm, and Fresh Time in the redeveloped former Kmart site. Quick Trip, located adjacent to Kia on 10th Avenue. Miss Melinda's Dance Studio and a Granite City Family and Cosmetic Dentistry are also located along Great Oak Drive. Plans are also underway to construct another Quick Trip along Great Oak Drive in 2017, and District Number 742 will be constructing an early childhood and community building adjacent to Discovery School. On the residential side, we had 8 new single-family homes constructed, totaling over $1.5 million in 2016. This is up from the previous year, which had 3 new homes totaling $535,000 in value. For 2017, McMeredith Development will be constructing a 60-unit senior apartment complex in the Windsor Green Edition, which is just behind Dick's and Fresh Time. They plan to begin construction hopefully this year with an opening to be determined, but hopefully 2018. 2016 brought new residents and property to Waite Park as well, with the remaining portion of St. Joseph Township being annexed. This area had been planned to be a part of Waite Park under an orderly annexation agreement with St. Joseph for 20 years. We are pleased to have completed this in 2016 and look forward to being able to have better land use control over this area as it continues to develop. One challenge we face in this area is addressing. These properties do not line up with our street grid system and have been we have been attempting to work with the post office as they have the authority over the addressing. The post office will allow us to change the streets portion of the address in the city, but is not willing to change the zip code from a St. Cloud zip code to a Waite Park zip code. From their perspective, the zip code is used for their mail routes. This becomes challenging for the city and the property owners as it creates problems for them getting deliveries and even with some of their basic mail service. Our only recourse is to file an appeal, and the city plans to do that this year. We hope that we can show the need for the change of the entire address, including the zip code. In anticipation of the annexation that still has a great deal of undeveloped property, we have over the course of the last 2 years partnered with St. Cloud State University to help us determine how to plan for future development. We were interested in using market data to look more in depth at our community, our future land use and development potential, as well as our community vision. This has resulted in a land use study that goes beyond putting colors on a map. It allows us to focus our efforts on future development that is market driven. The study has looked at our region in depth and has identified areas based on land use that could be supported by the market. It also evaluated our community demographics and has identified potential opportunities for the city of Waite Park. Our region provides many opportunities for all of our residents. We recognize that we better serve our community and the region by focusing on what parts of the region we can serve best, rather than trying to be everything to everyone. Here is a look at what our community survey said about our Waite Park community. You see the words on the screen, and the word flow chart represents some of the thoughts and feelings that were represented by the community survey. Based on the survey and other research conducted by SCSU, they have provided us with some great insight on what our community should focus on in the future. The recommendations that have been included in the land use study focus on specific areas where we believe our community can be effective. Here are a few of the recommendations. Make land use decisions that transform Waite Park into the Minnesota community that is most welcoming to seniors. The St. Cloud area is projected to experience an increase in age 70 and older population of more than 25,000 over the next 30 years. Waite Park has a comparative advantage in attracting seniors to the community, so an intentional land use strategy with seniors in mind already has a significant momentum. Number two would be become a magnet for the region's foreign-born population through land use strategies. Look at embracing the economic, social, and cultural potential of immigrants and the long-term potential they represent. use public policy to encourage home ownership, workforce development, entrepreneurship, and educational attainment to help integrate this population into the community. Number three, undertake a community beautification initiative, whether it is in the form of nicer green spaces or having cleaned up existing residential, commercial, and industrial properties, Waite Park needs to become more impressive. Number four, make future land use decisions to help Waite Park acquire a reputation as a recreational destination. With a growing share of age 65 and older population, Waite Park will need to continue to develop its recreational assets to meet the demands of this important population cohort. Use the community's recreational assets to attract visitors to stay overnight in Waite Park's hotels, eat in its restaurants, and shop in its stores. Number five, the St. Cloud area lacks a true business innovation center, a hub that helps entrepreneurs with business startups that provide venture capital, angel investing, and or other financial sources. These recommendations have really allowed us to see how our community is really changing and the importance for us to embrace it. We have many opportunities in front of us, and we now have a plan that will help us be successful. As we look at these recommendations in the building and planning department, we see opportunities in 2017 to focus on our rental properties. We have over 200 rental properties with over 2,000 total rental units. These would include apartment complexes and single family homes. These properties tend to increase our calls for service with both our police and fire departments and tend to be the area where we receive the most complaints on properties as well. The focus for 2017 will be on evaluating the calls we receive and trying to find ways to be proactive in addressing issues before they occur with rental inspections and education, as well as other strategies. Further recommendations from our land use study suggest that we consider placing a moratorium on rental properties and find ways to encourage more home ownership. No decisions have been made at this point, but this will be discussion for 2017 as we continue to address rental properties. Plans are also underway in 2017 to update some of our zoning ordinances. Several of these ordinances have not been updated for several years, and they need to be looked at closer to see what, if any, changes need to be made to keep them current with development trends. Our B3 Second Street South Corridor and our Highway 23 Entrance Corridor are two that we are evaluating right now. We are looking at lot sizes and development standards as part of this review. As we evaluate these ordinances, and we hope to continue to encourage development while balancing this with orderly growth that fits within the city's land use standards. Our planning and building departments continue to be committed to addressing the needs of the community and look forward to seeing what development opportunities will come in 2017. With that, I'll hand it over to Bill Schlunz, our Public Works Director. Thank you.
Public Works Department had a very busy year this year. We began construction at our new Public Works facility, which is probably the biggest project for us. It's long overdue. The facility was planned for about 10 years ago, and we'll replace our existing facility behind Gander Mountain. The new location is just west of McDowell on the former CIS property, if you're familiar with that area, adjacent to the new 17th Avenue that we just constructed last year. The building is under construction now and will be completed in fall. The site has enough room on it for a possible fire station in the future and is next to the future proposed amphitheater. The amphitheater is another exciting project that we've been working on as well. We have a beautiful piece of property known as the Old Transformer Quarry that we believe will be a great setting for the 4,000 to 5,000 seat amphitheater. As our land use study suggested, that making Waite Park a destination for recreation, we see the opportunity with the amphitheater to add other additional recreation that we believe will enhance the entire region. Proximity to the site to the Quarry Park will certainly help in making this a destination place. We have spent the last year touring a number of sites across the Midwest to learn from others' successes and some things that we choose to do differently. We have been able to take this information back and have been using it in our own design. We continue to work on the design of the facility and hope to begin construction in 2018 with an opening in 2019 if all goes according to plan. We have approached our legislatures and have a bonding request in for $5 million to assist us in the funding of this facility. The economic impacts of the amphitheater will have on our local Waite Park businesses, we believe, will be huge. As we continue to pursue this funding, We may need to reach out to all of you to contact your legislators to show the support for this project and assist us with funding. In 2016, we began work on a pickleball courts in Rivers Edge Park. Six courts will be completed in the spring and is one of our phases to finishing off the park. Park Board has spent the last year evaluating what other amenities we should put into the park to complete the build out. In addition to this, we are also excited for the construction of the Lake Gobegon Trail, the final piece between St. Joe and Waite Park. This section of trail will be completed in 2017, making a connection to Waite Park. This has been very key into getting it into the St. Cloud region, and we are pleased to have worked with the county on making this happen. As we look to plans for 2017, we will be evaluating what we should do with the old public works facility and trying to determine what the best use would that be. Also have a need to drill a new well and have begun the process of that with the engineering. We will need to determine the exact site and then have to plan this well up and running by the end of the year. We will be evaluating our library and its future needs to determine if the facility is large enough to handle the demands that are placed on this facility. We will also be looking at painting our water towers. We will be trying to do one in 2018 and one in 2019. And we also have to determine what is painted on each of these towers. We will be remodeling our council chambers this year and need to make improvements for our audio and visual, along with security improvements as well. The council has already authorized this work, and we should be working on it very soon. We are very excited for the many opportunities that are ahead of us in 2017 as we continue to be the dedicated and working for the city of Waite Park.
As luck would have it, our fire chief was unable to be here yesterday, having to take off of work to fight a fire, didn't allow him to be here today. So you get to listen to me again. So I'm going to give you the update on the fire department. And so in 2016, the fire department responded to 176 calls. This is up slightly from last year, where we had about 165. Many of the calls received are a result from apartment fires. With a large numbers of immigrant population, we do see a number of them cooking on real high temperatures, which does make it very difficult, and the alarms always get set off, and it does create some language barriers as well, so that has been a challenge. But we do believe that this is something that we can work with our police department and the apartment managers to provide more education to them to address these issues. In 2016, we purchased a new fire engine that replaces a 1975 engine. This fire engine was delivered to the city last week, and we hope to have this in operation in March or April of this year. We will spend the next month or so training on the new truck and equipping it with all of the necessary equipment. And as far as the old 1979 engine, we are looking for anyone that is interested into purchasing it. Due to its age, it really doesn't have a lot of value for a department, but it may have some value to a collector. So if any of you are a collector of fire trucks, go to our website. We have some information on it. Minimum bid is $2,500. So there is an opportunity for someone that might be looking. As we look to 2017, one of our biggest challenges still remains with recruitment of firefighters. In 2016, we actually had four firefighters that retired. Gary Curtis had 36 years in, Mike Post, 30 years, Jeff Moline, 20 years, and Robert Jagger, 11 years. Robert was also a longtime member of the Waite Park Rescue Squad before it was merged with the fire department. So we are in the process of hiring to replace these personnel, but this becomes more challenging year after year because of the commitment and training to be a firefighter. We could use help and support of the Waite Park business owners, specifically encouraging employees to join and allow them to respond to fire calls. This is crucial for our daytime response. So why consider being a firefighter? Here are some of those reasons. There are many benefits to allowing your employees to being a part of the fire department from our perspective. We hope that you will consider encouraging your employees to be a part of the department, as it is important to give back to your community in this way to ensure that we can continue to provide fire service in this manner. Finding dedicated, quality individuals to be a part of the department will continue to be a challenge without more individuals willing to step up. So if you're wanting to learn more about that, there's some contact information for you right there. And with the recent annexation, the fire department will also be looking to form relations with the recently annexed businesses. We will be in contact with some of them during the course of this year for pre-planning and tours. In addition, we are also working on updating our fire ordinances and our burning permit process to make it easier for property owners to obtain burning permits. The fire department continues to be dedicated to providing the best service to our community. Our community continues to change, and we are committed to meeting the demands it places on our department. We hope you consider becoming part of our department to ensure that the service can continue to be provided affordably to our community. And now I'm going to turn it over to Dave Benchrud, our police chief.
Thanks, Shauna. Dave Benchrud, police chief in Waite Park, and I'm fully aware that I'm probably the one that stands between you and the opportunity to get back to work, so I will try to be as brief as I can. Want to just share a few things from the police department. As you can see on the graph, 2016, we passed the 10,000 ICR, or what we call ICR, or call for service mark, which for us is a all-time high. The good news is when it comes to our crime calls, they were down about 7%, which is a good thing. So our overall calls were up about 12%. Most of that was because of non-crime-related types of activity. We saw a big increase in the number of traffic crashes, medicals. Traffic enforcement is up a little bit. It's a good thing. Some of the things that we've seen, and when I typically do this in the past, is I want to highlight a couple things that tend to impact businesses specifically. When I look at individual crimes, where they are up in our community is financial-related crimes. Forgery and fraud are really high right now. We right now, as of the first of the year, or since the first of the year, we have a backlog of about 20 forgery fraud cases. That's almost enough work for another investigator. And so that's a little concerning. We have seen increases in identity theft. And as we have become more dependent on online banking and some of those kinds of things, we seem to be more vulnerable. Mail theft is still a huge problem. Protect your payroll checks. Protect your mail. We have heard, and Alicia shared with me earlier, that they're even going after now the blue mailboxes, for crying out loud. Now, I can't say that we've seen that in Waite Park yet, but washing of checks, payroll checks are a big target for those who are involved in that. So, you know, take care of your stuff. Likewise, you know, if there's anything that we can do as a department, you know, Alicia's in a position to give you some direction when it comes to target hardening kind of things, making your business safe. Our burglaries are way down. We had 54 in 2015. Last year we had 15, and I was very pleased by that. Most of our burglaries do tend to focus on our commercial sector businesses. 2015, we had a lot of storage units that were hit, so that kind of inflated it a little bit. But and there's probably a lot of reasons for the decrease in burglaries. But if we can be a resource for you to kind of make your properties more secure, that would be great. We'd love to do that. Also, we are doing more and more training when it comes to active threat. So if you have a business with a number of employees and want to be as prepared as you can be for, God forbid, something like that happening, we're in a position to help you with that as well. So, again, calls are up, but on a positive side, it's crime is down, so that is a good thing. And I think, you know, part of the reason for the decrease in burglaries and maybe other crimes is the fact that, you know, we have added staff to our police department. When I started in Waite Park, we had 12 officers. Now we have 18, including two part-time officers. So we're able to patrol more effectively and provide more coverage. We're able to handle more of our own calls for service and less dependent on our neighbors. We do work very closely with our neighboring departments when it comes to some of the high risk types of calls that we get from time to time. But again, having the extra resources is a nice thing. We've also added a part-time transcriptionist which takes a lot of pressure off of our record staff. We have almost every weekend we have an in custody, which requires a lot of work on the weekends to get a case into court. So that's always a big thing. Technology advancements, we've made several. We always are trying to be as efficient as we can. Right now, this past year, we are have revamped our city website, and you maybe have seen that. We're very excited about being able to get more involved in social media. So you're going to see a Facebook page for the city, police department. We're going to start tweeting, and Alicia is going to be doing a lot of that for us. And so we're looking forward to that. We have printers in our squad cars now, so officers can, their office is becoming much more mobile. They can print forms out in their squad cars now, and so a lot of neat things are happening in that regard. I also want to share that, you know, I'm very, very proud of our department and the lead role that we have taken, along with our neighboring cities, to combat sex trafficking and prostitution. We've had significant involvement in getting several individuals sent to prison for a very long time for sex trafficking, and we are working very closely with other law enforcement agencies, social service providers, the faith community, to try to figure out a way to get women out of that lifestyle, get them a safe place, so that they can maybe change the direction of their life. And so I'm very proud of the efforts that we've made to try to combat that issue. And I've often said that Waite Park is kind of a unique community in the sense that we're a smaller department, but we're dealing with a lot of more urban issues like prostitution, financial crimes, and things like that. And with that, one of the things that we're trying to do is get in place as a city the ability to license and have a hand in regulating hotel-motel business. We had a motel now in the past that was a lot of problems for us, and probably most cities our size don't need that kind of authority, but given the dynamics of this area and our community and whatnot, we feel that it's important for Waite Park to have that ability to license and regulate local hotels and motels to avoid the kinds of things that we saw, trafficking and women being prostituted. So we recently got approval from the Stearns County to have that ability, and I believe we're looking at some state legislation that would allow a city of our size that ability to license and regulate and deal with problem properties like that should we have to. Hopefully we won't, but again, just to keep our community safe, we feel it's good to have that capability. Department training, we're really emphasizing more and more the active threat training, like I talked about, doing more scenario-based training. And we saw that pay a lot of dividends. We had a couple incidents at the mall. Obviously, the stabbing that occurred with primarily St. Cloud, but we were significantly involved in that incident. And I could really tell that our training in that area paid a lot of dividends during that incident. So we're going to continue to work on that. And again, if we can help your business become more safe, please let us know about that. Community outreach is another goal that we set for the department for this year. And I think the slides talked about the fact that Waite Park is becoming much more diverse, and that creates challenges for our police department as well when it comes to communication and things like that. And we feel we have a pretty strong and I hope a good reputation within the community, particularly the business community. But we know that many of our new immigrants may not have the trust level with policing that they we would like to see. So we're going to try to make a difference in that area. We are in the process of organizing a youth soccer program for kids in the kind of Waite Park, West Metro area. We have a lot of youth, primarily Somali youth, that have little recreational opportunities, particularly during the summer. There are a lot of things being offered on the east side, Sulky Field, north side at Whitney. There's not a lot out here on the west end. And so this summer, we're under Alicia Magus's guidance, we're going to try to offer some youth programming. It's a little unique situation for us being a police department, but we're going to try to fill that gap as best we can. We're partnering with the school district, St. John's and St. Ben's for some internship support. And we really, Stearns County Public Health is another one. Central Minnesota Youth Soccer Association is going to provide some coaching. We really, I don't have much of a budget for this kind of a thing. So if there is a business that would be interested or willing to help sponsor our youth soccer program, we don't need a lot of funds, but it would be really nice if we could give the kids a T-shirt or something like that. We're probably going to run, what do we say, Alicia, from like June to July, something like that? 8 weeks. And so this is kind of our first step towards doing this kind of thing. We hope to maybe evolve and include basketball and some of those other kind of activities. So community outreach remains a big task for us. So if you might be interested, talk to Alicia or I. We'd really appreciate the support from the business community, if at all possible. And then the last thing I just want to share as far as a goal, and I apologize, I'm getting over a cold. I think I'm maybe losing my voice here. But one of our goals for this year is to really try to improve in our internal communication. You know, we're growing. We've grown staff-wise. We've grown in geography. Waite Park now is about 12 square miles with the annexation area. And with the amphitheater, and I haven't been significantly involved in that, but I'm very excited about that. I think it's going to be, if we can get it done, it's going to be a really, really cool addition to this area, to the city. It is going to create some work for public safety and policing. And so what goes along with that growth is just the need to make sure that our policy and procedures are current, up to date. And so we're going to, that we have all of the internal communication mechanisms in place that we need to. We're looking at what other ordinances do we might need to incorporate to make keep our community safe when it comes to the kind of growth that we anticipate seeing. So we're kind of looking with an eye to the future a little bit when it comes to public safety and what those needs might be. So with that, I appreciate, that's all I really had to say, and I appreciate the opportunity to give you an update today.
Well, just in summary, as we continue to look forward, we are focusing our efforts on embracing our changing community. From our use of technology, our demand for 24/7 services, our need to enhance security, to our changing demographics, we are a community that recognizes our need to adapt and be forward-thinking. Waite Park continues to make great progress, and I attribute this success to not one person, but as a result of the good work and intentions of many. This includes my partners in elected office, our great volunteers, our city department heads, officers, staff, and the public. Whether it is a resident, a business owner, or volunteers, I am extremely thankful to all of you who have participated in the past and look forward to the continued efforts in the years to follow. We are a city that is truly prepared and committed to embracing our changing community. Some of this wouldn't happen. I just want to address our city engineers here, SEH. They've kind of kept us on the straight and narrow, so thank Terry. Life is good in Waite Park. Thanks for coming.